I'm just saying, Kenny, but the big markets still have an attraction. Bright lights and that star power can help boost your profile and earning potential.
Boy, just amazing architecture here. The view of the Capitol building in beautiful downtown Denver, Colorado. Everyone is in their seats here at the Pepsi Center as the Nuggets look to grab a win here in downtown Denver, Colorado. Last game for the Hawks, it was a loss to the Charlotte Hornets. And that does your confidence, guys, no favor. They got manhandled in that one. It wasn't pretty.
Yeah, in a game where offensively they were about as inconsistent as you're ever going to see them.
They needed to make a few runs, but it just never happened for them. And when you can't string things together, it's tough sledding. It's a tough way to go.
Looking at the starting five for the Atlanta Hawks. Millsap at power forward with Horford at the center. Teague and Korver are the guards. And it's Bazemore at the three spot.
Such a strong finisher on the fast break.
And Greg, I love the fact he's always in control. Even though he's going at breakneck speed, he still maintains his body control.
Pass to Jokic. And he finishes it off with a one-handed jam.
Tell you what, he's not an easy guy to stop when he's got his sight on the rim.
Never has been, never will be. He is a determined finisher.
Did he just go chop-chop there? Put that one hand, tomahawk slam.
And you know, guys, a high-energy post player like Kenneth Faried excels at doing the dirty work. As a matter of fact, he's nicknamed the Manimal for good reason. Very few players in the league possess this combination of energy and aggressiveness.
Fast break, the Hawks. And here they go. Bazemore gets the bucket. And now we'll get a perspective here on how the hustle game has been going for Atlanta.
Boy, they've really amped up the pressure at the defensive end, guys, and have piled up the steals in the early going.
And also defensively, they've been able to cause some turnovers tonight. And that also builds confidence and gives you momentum.
Eyes again, and Faried lays it in. Faried's got his first 2 points of the night.
Really strong rebounding on the interior, and he gets the easy putback.
Teague up top, guarded by Nelson. Out to the right wing, Millsap to DeBazeman. Back to Millsap, stolen by Faried. Here's Harris, and that one's good. And this game is tied up now.
Really crisp, intelligent passing to make that basket possible.
And Teague, here we go. He kicks to Korver. Back to Teague. Let's the three fly. Denver. the miss. They come in fresh off a win against the Warriors.
And we've talked about how in the NBA you've got to earn your points the hard way. And that really wasn't the case in that game for them.
No, there was no hard way about it. I mean, they got their points easily on dunks and layups against a defense that really didn't offer much of a fight.
Here's Teague, following the basket by Kenneth Faried. Teague, the pass to Porter. Takes a three. It's hauled in by Harris. The Nuggets have gone 4-5 from the field so far. Faried with it. He's picked up by Milsom. And that one's good, Jokic.
Really not hard to see why they're giving up points on this run. I mean, they're just giving them too many looks inside.
Yeah, and usually when a team goes on a run like this, it's because they are getting too many opportunities on the inside. Make them beat you from deep.
Got a good look, though. I thought that was going to go down.
Yeah, the D, though, just enough to bother the rhythm on that one part.
And he gets it to go.
What hand? He broke the D down to the ground with that move.
The Hawks trail by six. Nelson with the steal. 5 second differential between the shot clock and the game clock. Coach is liking Clark what he's seeing from his offense.
And dude, why wouldn't he? I mean, guys, they're filling it up with ease, executing, getting quality shots. I mean, this is fun to watch.
And guys, they put the defense on the defensive.
Pretty, pretty pass. Timely recognition as to where the open man was.
Out to Gallinari. He caught it up in time, but it wouldn't. And the first quarter is in the books. Second about ready to get underway. And some stats here, guys. The scoring breakdown for the Nuggets.
You know, guys, we've really seen them do a lot of damage in the paint so far.
And also another aspect of their game that's been super so far tonight is how they've been sharing the basketball.
And now, brought to you by Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go. Let's reset our lineups. So on the floor for Denver. Moutier out there at four. Then there's Jusuf Ljubic. Then it's Will Barton. And it's Arthur in at the power forward position. The Nuggets leading by four. Up ramp from the most intriguing draft picks of this past summer. Emmanuel Moutier can be a game-changing player, was going to play, Clark, as you recall, at SMU for Larry Brown.
He sure was and went overseas instead, so we don't know a ton about him other than his reputation is sterling. Now we'll see if he can live up to it.
And that one's good. Schroeder.
You might not think of him as a laser three-point shooter, but that shot was there for him, and he had to take it.
Now, here's Moutier. He's guarded by Schroeder. And so it looks like Denver will retain possession here.
And how about Moutier, guys? He has a very interesting upbringing. Born in the Congo, grew up in Texas, then spent last season in China. Already a very well-traveled young man for players of his age.
Splitter, that's good. Timeout is called. First of the game.
They can't guard us on the perimeter. Spread the floor. I see the top. Spacing. Spacing.
A playmaker for his squad.
The Nuggets trail. Dishes it to Nurkic. To the paint. Here's Moutier. Takes the assist and lays it in. Picked out the pass nicely.
The defense not putting up any fight on the inside. They've allowed 10 straight points in the paint.
That's not the kind of streak you want to be part of defensively. Tighten it up, fellas.
This has been a thriller. You cannot say enough about the way these two teams have competed.
All indications, Greg, are that this game is going down to the wire. I'd be surprised, actually shocked, if it ended any other way.
Now, here's Schroeder. He's a good contributor to his team, averaging about 10.5 points a game. There's the three. Another three for Atlanta.
This offense just continues to impress.
Yeah, getting hotter and hotter, Greg. They're really cooking now. Actually, cooking with gas. You know what kind of heat that is.
Yeah, it looks like he saw some things out there that need to be adjusted. He's going to take a break here and talk it over.
Hey, you know, coaches sometimes need a break in the action to rethink and retool a bit. Anytime you're in that situation, it makes sense to use the timeout.
And Atlanta calls their first timeout of the game. And Jusuf Nurkić, really a big, good-looking young prospect. He's the guy that took Mozgov's place in Denver.
Yeah, originally, Kevin, drafted by the Bulls at number 16 and traded to Denver, as you indicated. The sheer size alone, 7 feet, 280, makes him a force on the glass.
Now here's Schroeder. 6 points for him. Scott can't get it to go. And oh, here we go. Foy's got it. The fast break chance. Barton, no luck.
Oh, you've got to be able to deliver when you get a bunny like that. That's just too easy of a shot to miss.
And a foul called on the shot. Got him on the way up that time, so he'll shoot two right here.
And Dennis Schroeder out of Germany. His teammates give him a hard time about putting mayonnaise on everything. He eats a turkey burger with mayo before every game. And let me tell you, no need to change, because he's settling in just fine.
Denver with a platoon swap here on the floor. And the Hawks will go for a different look here. Al Horford check in for Splinter. Millsap comes in for Mike Scott. Kent Bazemore is checked in for Cephalosha. And it's Korver in for Tim Hardaway Jr.
Wow, that is a strong move there to go in for the dunk.
And I like the job the defense did to not let him have it. I mean, make him earn it at the line.
He doesn't get the second one. And Schroeder, who's out of Germany, a pretty wealthy country, but he had a pretty scrabble upbringing.
Yeah, you know, he had some brushes with authority early on in his life. He's still relatively young, so in the past, I think he's in a really ideal situation in Atlanta right now.
And the ball goes out of bounds. It's touched by Fareed.
Yeah, and I think he was surprised to see that pass coming his way and just really reacted too late.
Jeff Teague, who's checked in for Dennis Schroeder. Stolen by Fareed. And pushing it up, here's Denver. Harris with the ball and stolen by Horford. Fast break, the Hawks. Korver with the ball. Here's Bazemore. And three chances on that possession, but they just couldn't find a way to score. Ball knocked loose. The bounce, Atlanta takes possession.
That is just a careless turnover. You've got to be smarter in those exchanges.
Here's Atlanta now. They're on a 14-5 run here. Millsap has the open look. The Hawks again can't hit.
I guess even he has to miss one of those once in a while.
Knocked loose. Millsap with the steal.
And they can guarantee this is the last possession of the quarter if they hold it.
And I'm guessing that's exactly what they're probably going to do here.
And there's the 8-second call as they can't get it across half court in time. Here's Jokic. Good! And a nice assist from Nelson. He's got 6. Just 4 seconds left in the first half of basketball. And Jeff T with the 3. And the Hawks lead by 6. And we finish one half of basketball. Hawks lead by 6.
Jameer, what needs...
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Staring at the ball. Open up
Welcome back, everybody. It's the 2K Sports Half, a competitive matchup for Atlanta in the first quarter. The largest lead for them during the period was 4. The second quarter was when things really came together for them. And that'll do it for now as we send you back to Kevin Harlan for the start.
Welcome back, everybody. The start of the second half getting underway. Both teams battling hard through the first half.
Look at what Schroeder has done so far. He's got 10 points, and he's got 2 baskets out in 3-point land.
I'm sure they should get a few more of those.
On the court for Atlanta, Teague and Korver are the guards. Millsap, the power forward, with Horford at the center. And it's Bazemore at the 3. Last season, we saw Al Horford rounding back into form. Good to see that after what had been his second season-ending pectoral muscle tear back in late 2013.
Exactly. I mean, the Hawks just had to bide their time while their best player was out. You saw once he returned, though, he makes a big difference for them.
The Hawks have been perfect at the line so far, albeit just 2 for 2.
And really, the form at the line all season has been terrific, 79% as a team.
And guys, that's really an upgrade over how they shot last season. Not a huge upgrade, but an upgrade nonetheless.
And for me, Horford, one of the most unappreciated stars in the league. When he's healthy, he's every bit the franchise player because he really has no weakness. He does pretty much everything well on the floor. And there's a pattern starting to take shape here. They're working it inside and getting good shots from close range.
Well, I agree with you. 4 of their last 5 baskets have been exactly of that variety.
And Horford, I mean, this guy does it all on the floor. But for me, his leadership, that's one of those real intangibles. And he's unselfish, all about his teammates, and completely focused on winning. So when your best player has that commitment, it has to rub off on the other player.
The Nuggets trail by 11. Out to the right wing. Here's Gallinari.
And he just leaves the D in the dust and explodes to the basket.
You're right. Clark, maybe a momentum changer right there, huh?
It could be, Kevin. I mean, a dunk like that can sometimes get an opponent reeling.
Special thanks to Kia for that sweet Kia Slam Cam replay. Yusuf Nurkic, he's checked in for the Nuggets. Mike Muscala is checked in for the Hawks. Bazemore hits the bucket.
He shot the ball exceptionally well as they've built this lead for themselves here.
And Kit Bazemore, the long-armed lefty out of Old Dominion, where he was the Division I defensive player of the year back in 2011, a 5-year senior. He graduated with 2 degrees, one in criminal justice, the other in human service.
Terrell Arthur, he's checked in for Denver. Arthur comes in for Gary Harris. And he was fouled on the way up. 2 free throws now for him. And Bazemore grew up in a small town, Kelford, North Carolina. Clark, less than 300 people.
And a very tight-knit community, as you might expect, Kevin. His uncle owned the local diamond. And you see that in his demeanor. Very social, a humble guy. He's really a nice presence in his locker room. And now we can see them really working it inside.
Yeah, Clark, quality looks at the rim. That's fueling this run.
Now, here is Nelson. He's been patient so far, nothing yet on the scoreboard.
You know, another point of contention between every NBA fan is whether or not the age restriction is a good thing. Some want it increased, others want it gone altogether. You know, for me, it's a matter of whether or not you as a team feel that that player can make an impact on your roster.
And the Nuggets making a change here. Foy's checked in. Moutier, he's checked in for Jameer Nelson. Arthur. It will go down, and the Hawks lead is cut down now to just 12 points with the basket from Burton.
3 for 3, and that's always a good way to start the second half.
And there are arguments, Clark, on both sides for the NBA and the age restriction it has currently right now. Having one seems to help the level of play overall, but I think there are some improvements that can be made.
Yeah, with the D-League coming into its own, though, Kevin, the discussion has opened up again. NBA teams used to not have a place for high school players. The D-League could serve in that regard now. But having a restriction is something that I think has helped the NBA. I actually would like to see it be 20 years old.
Me too.
And a moment now to check out the numbers for Millsap. He's been fantastic over the last 10 games or so. 8 in steals. And, of course, rim protection always at a premium. That's an important part of his game. Top 20 in blocks per.
And talk about highway robbery. I mean, jumping the passing lane, snatching away your dribble. He'll take it from you.
So he gets the whistle. Contact on the way up and 2 shots coming up.
Kyle Korver enjoying a career renaissance, if you will, here in his 30s. A former late second-round pick. He's kicked around the league a little bit. He's really found his niche here in the motion offense of the Atlanta Hawks.
A little background on Kyle Korver. Drafted 51st by the Nets back in 2003. They sold his rights to the Sixers for a little over $100,000 and used the proceeds to pay for their summer league fee.
Well, that, and they also bought a new color copy. Whatever that information is worth, it might sound like a mistake in hindsight, but I heard that machine is very reliable.
And Millsap slaps it in.
Boy, he threw out some punishment with that two-hand throwdown.
And Clark, now's the time to do it. Continue to attack that rim.
And stolen by Jeff Teague. Now the Hawks moving it the other way, and the slam dunk by Bazemore.
I think that play sort of sums up what we've seen throughout, just simply being outplayed both sides of the ball. Smart basketball defensively turning into quick points.
And that can't continue. I mean, if they hope to get back in this game, I mean, it's really deflating from a morale standpoint. They need stops and points, not turnovers.
And the dunk by Arthur.
And if that doesn't get them fired up, guys, nothing will.
Greg, just what the doctor ordered, huh? Some high-flying antics to narrow the deficit.
Tell you what, fellas, that could give them the energy boost they've been looking for.
Oh, terrific way to finish that move there, going to the basket.
Foy dishes to Moody. Goes up the baseline. The shot is good off the backboard.
A quick trigger. And from that range, if he senses the defenders have backed off, hard to get that one off with the size difference there. That makes it a tough individual matchup for him, especially down low.
Well, took on the big guys going in there and challenging them like he did. But, boy, that was a nice job.
Teague can't hit.
You could tell he assumed he'd be able to beat the defensive coverage, even though it was all over.
Expanding his range. Moutier, no good. Here's Bazemore. It's tipped. Got a piece of it. And so it looks like Denver will retain possession here. Four. The shot no good.
Your Nuggets dancers.
And we're rolling here again with the fourth quarter. Might not come down to the wire, but you never know. Atlanta leading by 16. Gallinari sits outside at 3 with Fareed at the 4. Nelson is out there with Harris. That's the group on the 4 for Denver.
You know, he might be small for a center, but it doesn't really matter because he can jump out of the building. Certainly that shot well within his range.
I would hope so.
And especially when he caps it off with a steady one-hand game.
And finished off by Horford.
Good job threading that pass into the lane. I like his vision, guys. He sees everything.
Nelson kicks to Fareed. And the foul on Mike Scott. That is his first foul of the game. Gallinari passes to Jokic.
Yeah, I like that they haven't lost their aggressiveness here in the second, despite being down.
That's exactly when you need to be aggressive, Greg. You know that. I mean, another good job, though, of drawing contact and getting to the free throw line.
Splitters checked in for the Hawks. And they can't make the second free throw either. Missing both. Here's Schroeder. Offline with his 3. The Nuggets trail by 18. Gallinari dishes to Nelson. About a minute played here in the fourth quarter. Jokic, no good. The Hawks have gone 2 of 3 from the field to get the fourth quarter started. And here's Schroeder. He feeds it to Hardaway. Kicks to Schroeder. just 5 on the clock. For the 3. But they get it back. And the pass to Cephalosha. Feeds it to Splitter. Deflects the pass. It's stolen by Harris. 5-on-3 break. Here's Fareed. And it's sent back by Horford. Fires the 3. And it's Schroeder missing. For Denver, they've gone 1-of-3 from the field to start the fourth quarter. But they recover it. And Fareed kicks to Gallinari. And that's a foul. It's called on Tabe Cephalosha. That's his first foul. The Atlanta making some changes. Paul Millsaps checked in for Splitter. Ken Bazemore comes in for Cephalosha. And it's Korver in for Tim Hardaway Jr. TD's checked in for Dennis Schroeder. Here's Fareed. And the call will be against Jeff T. That is his first foul of the game.
And the next one puts them in the bonus.
Yep, they'll be trying to draw that next foul quickly so they can start getting those easy chances at the strike.
Fareed, and he dunks it down.
Man, he slams it home and gets a little camera time on the backside of it.
He spent a while up there on the rim.
And I like the fact that the ref's going to give him a little bit of leeway there and a lot more than they used to.
Here's Bazemore. Gallinari with the steals. Here's Harris, rips down the breakaway slam.
Quick hands on the steal and then just mad hops on the slam.
Great sequence for them defensively and Clark offensively.
Well, one usually leads to the other, Kevin. That's just good, aggressive, attacking basketball both ends.
Martin shoved in for Denver. Baseline Jay on the way, and that one goes long. The Nuggets trail by 14. Rebounded by Korver.
Excellent. Really solid job, actually, by the defense to get in his way as he was going up for that one.
Here's Millsap. And it's going to be 2 free throws. Drew contact on the shot. And he isn't the biggest body at 6'8", but Paul Millsap, very effective.
And part of his being underrated and underestimated, I think, is due to that size. Folks are finally starting to come around. That kind of production he's put up will make that happen.
And Millsap, with over a 7-foot wingspan and also just a great nose for the ball. He gets you rebounds, blocks, and he leads all power forwards in steals pretty much every season.
And Nelson gets it to go.
And so only one team answered the bell tonight, guys. Not a monster blowout by any means, but still a double-digit victory for the Hawks.
A few times this season, turnovers have cost him, but Clark, they really kept the ball under control.
I thought they were both focused and relentless, Kevin.
And so this is going to end up as victory number 24 on the year.
And tonight, they took the time they needed, made the plays they had to when they had to, and that's why they're going up one zip in their 3-game season series against the Nuggets.
And when you look back at this one, what an amazing performance this was for Jeff Teague. He was extremely efficient offensively, got good looks, and really knocked down big shots all game long.
And the Hawks with a completely new group on the floor. And it's out of bounds. The Nuggets able to retain possession here. Boy kicks to Nurkic. Atlanta with the rebound. They led by as many as 18 points.
And speaking of Millsap's defense, I mean, he can switch out and cover perimeter players as well. His smaller stature gives him that versatility, but then the long wingspan allows him to still bang with the biggies.
Nurkic kicks to Barton. Sinks the three-pointer. Here's Splitter. And so it's the Hawks taking care of business in this one. And in the win, a comfortable win in what was, I think, a pretty hostile environment.
It really was. You know, it's never going to be easy on the road, but they didn't have too many problems with that tonight.
And that about wraps it up. This is Kevin Harlan thanking you for watching. And now we'll head over to the studio with Ernie Johnson.
The 2K Sports Postgame Show.
Ernie Johnson here again with Shaquille O'Neal and Kenny Smith. Without further ado, let's present to you our Jordan Player of the Game. Jeff Teague. He's not always known to make the big headlines or get a lot of media attention, but he does make the big plays, and he made them throughout this one.
Boom, boom, boom. That's right, Ernie. Instruments. This guy was instrumental in the night in making sure they avoid.